There are various steps to take when building custom software. Each step in the process has its own importance and works together with other steps to create a successful custom software development project. For example, user experience design guides user interface design during the design process. Project managers then use these designs during project planning to create user stories, which are used by developers to code the platform. In this video, we're going to cover the following topics involved with the process of software development: who to hire, workflow methods, project planning, project management, UX and UI design, front-end and back-end development, integration, quality assurance, and deployment. Let's go ahead and cover who to hire when building custom software. It takes a full product development team to build custom software. For this, you can build a team of freelancers, hire an internal team, or work with an agency. So first off, a freelancer is a self-employed individual who is skilled in a specific area. Depending on the project, one freelancer may not be enough. This would then require a freelance team made of several experienced professionals. Because they don't work for an employer, they determine what they want to charge, who they want to work with, and how many projects they want to work on. This often makes building a freelance team a cost-friendly option. An in-house development team is a group of professionals who work in your office. To create an internal team, businesses must build a new department and hire employees fit for the open roles. Determining processes and finding professionals is often costly and can take a large amount of time. When the project is complete, your business may not need this department anymore, resulting in unneeded employees and resources. Next up, let's look at agencies. Agencies are established teams of professionals who work together seamlessly. Software development agency teams commonly consist of project managers, designers, developers, and more, providing expertise from a variety of fields. Agencies can be hired exactly when you need them and offer long-term support at a low cost to your business. Unlike internal teams, agencies already have processes in place. For guidance determining which agency may be best fit for your project, try visiting clutch.co. Workflow methods. When deciding who to hire to build your custom software, be sure to consider the methodology behind their process. Choosing the right process can save you large amounts of time and money in the long run. Depending on who you hire, you may need to implement your own process. There are two main methodologies you can use to guide your development process: waterfall and agile. Waterfall methodology. The waterfall method breaks the steps of a project into different phases, each having their own tasks and objectives. By utilizing the waterfall workflow, the development of one phase can only start when the previous phase is complete. This means the project doesn't allow for any changes to the custom application until it has completely gone through all of its phases. And then the other methodology is agile methodology. Unlike the waterfall method, agile methodology doesn't rely on the status of its preceding phase. Instead, the agile method allows multiple phases to work simultaneously within small iterative periods, also referred to as sprints. This allows the custom application to be reviewed and improved several times before the project is complete. You can find out more information about agile versus waterfall software development methodologies here listed in the link description below. Project planning. Project planning is a discipline that states how a project should be completed within a specified time frame. During this process, the team focuses on determining business goals, setting a detailed timeline, defining project stages, and project management. Project management. Project management is the process of achieving all project goals within the given constraints, scope, time, and budget. Common activities within project management include measuring progress, delegating tasks, allocating resources, and communicating effectively. Design. UX and UI design are two similar but different elements that contribute to consumer experience. While user experience design is focused on problem solving and user interaction, user interface design is the design of the visual elements of the application. UX design. Short for user experience design, UX puts the user first and considers the overall feel of the interactions and experience with a product. UX design involves problem solving to determine how to make experiences and interactions most valuable to the user. Wireframes. Wireframes are simple black and white blueprints of an application's layout and functionality. They are an affordable commitment and invaluable tool that helps pave the way to the future of your product. Wireframes can improve communication amongst the team, prevent miscommunication by serving as a clear visual representation, enable focus on user experience factors such as layouts and user interaction, allow you to be proactive by exposing potential issues early on, help define your MVP, and eliminate unnecessary features to prevent misuse of time and money. User research. User research focuses on understanding a user's behaviors, needs, and motivations through observation techniques, task analysis, and other feedback methodologies. Some user research methodologies include desk research, research interviews, focus groups, intercept studies, ethnographic research, competitor usability testing, and card sorting. If you'd like to learn more about these user research methods, I highly recommend checking out Chris Nodder's user research courses, which are linked in the description below. I personally took his course a while back, and I can happily say it's one of the most effective courses for learning about user research. UI design. Also known as user interface design, UI focuses on the user's visual interactive experience, such as tapping a button or swiping through images. What happens when a user clicks on this or taps on that? User interface design creates an emotional connection with the user and contributes to the presentation, look, and feel of a product. Component boards. A component board is an outline of a digital product's color palette, font system, and interface components. They include any components and assets used in the digital product with specific functionality within the application. Component boards prep developers with the resources required to start the project and take away the guesswork from front-end development by allowing developers to quickly access the designer's intention for the product. Prototyping. Prototypes are basically a more advanced version of wireframes, providing an in-depth rendering of an application's design and functionality. This gives a user a realistic idea of their future digital product. Development. In general, web development can be broken down into two specializations, front-end and back-end. Front-end development focuses on the visual elements of a website or app that a user interacts with, while back-end development focuses on the parts of a website or app that users can't really see. Front-end development, commonly referred to as the client side, front-end development includes everything the user experiences directly. Front ends make up the user interface, the space where the user and a computer system interact, and the user experience, so how the user interacts with and experiences the product. There are three main front end languages: HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Back end development. Also known as the server side, back end development includes the behind the scene elements that the user doesn't see. Back-end development is in charge of the server and communication between the front-end and database. A database is simply where the information is stored so that users can view or interact with it when desired. Overall, the back-end works closely with the front-end to deliver the final products to the end user. Integration. Custom software integration takes multiple pieces of software and aggregates them into a single application. Integration creates a multifunctional application that can help with your organization's efficiency. Existing databases. Database integration is the inclusion of an already existing database in your own application. For example, many healthcare companies have stored data about their patients and may find it useful for this same information to be made available to their employees on their new software. Third-party data. Third-party software integration is the inclusion of an outsourced application program interface, or API for short, in your own application. For instance, your business may want to integrate Google Maps to your software to allow your users to access location-based experiences such as navigation or tracking systems. Quality assurance. Quality assurance is a process that assures all software development processes, methods, activities, and work items are monitored to ensure proper quality of the software. During this process, QA professionals check to make sure the platform is completely usable. They look for any potential issues that may be present in the software. This could include elements that may be confusing to the typical user, or buttons, links, and CTAs that don't do what they're supposed to do. Effective quality assurance results in a product that has been tested thoroughly, making it of high quality, without bugs, and fully understandable to users. Deployment. Deployment is the process of making your digital product available on a production environment. Some steps involved in this process include alpha and beta testing. Alpha testing is performed by internal members to determine any potential issues and bugs, while beta testing is performed by real users of the software application in a real environment. Alpha testing. Alpha testing is the initial testing phase of your digital product to ensure that it meets business requirements and functions properly. This is typically performed by internal quality assurance employees, as well as some members of your own team. Alpha testing is generally restricted to less than 100 people to eliminate apparent issues before releasing the product to actual users. Beta testing. Beta testing is performed after alpha testing is complete. Beta testing is a testing phase in which the nearly completed digital product is given to a targeted group of users to see how it performs in the real world. While alpha testing involves less than 100 people, beta testing can involve anywhere from 100 to 1,000 users to gain a larger volume of helpful feedback about the product. After beta testing is complete, the digital product is moved to a live production environment, such as the Google Play Store or Apple App Store. In summary, building custom software is a complex process that requires a large amount of strategy and knowledge. This is why choosing the right team to build your digital product is such a crucial step in your investment journey. To learn more about how to build custom software, you can go ahead and check out the blog that is listed in the description below. If you like the video, go ahead and give us a like and subscribe and ring the bell to stay notified. And if you have any further questions, go ahead and leave those in the comment section. All right, have a good one.